Step 7, transformation. During the transformation step, we are going to add the ligated plasmid to chemically competent E. coli cells and expose the cell suspension to a heat shock that will introduce the DNA inside the cells. I start the transformation by taking the competent cells out of a minus 80 degree freezer and thawing them on ice for 15 minutes. Each of those tubes contains 200 microliters of competent cells prepared for one transformation. Notice that competent cells are sensitive to room temperature exposure, and therefore I put them on ice the very moment I remove them from the freezer. After incubating them for 15 minutes on ice, I'm going to label the tubes as vector plus insert and vector control, and I'm going to add the corresponding ligation reaction to each of the tubes. Then I mix the DNA with the cell suspension by gently tapping on the tube. I put the cells back on ice and leave them there for another 30 minutes. For the heat shock, I transfer the tubes into a floating rack. And put them into a 42 degree water bath for 1 minute. After the heat shock, the cells go back on ice for another 5 minutes. Now I am going to add 800 microliters of LB medium without antibiotics. And I will shake the tubes in a 37 degree shaker for 45 minutes so they develop antibiotic resistance. Before plating, I'm going to reduce the volume back to 200 microliters by spinning down the tubes in the microcentrifuge for 1 minute. Then I remove 800 microliters of supernatant and resuspend the cells in the remaining 200 microliters of LB. Now we are ready to plate the cells. For plating, we will need a gas burner, two LB plates, a beaker with ethanol, and a spreader. First, I'm going to transfer the cells from the tubes to the plates. Then I will burn the spreader. Chill it down against LB agar without touching the cells, and spread the cells around. Then I burn the spreader again in the flame, dip it in the ethanol, burn again, chill it against the plate, and spread the cells around. I will incubate the plates in the lid-up position for 30 minutes at 37 degrees to dry the liquid on the plate surface. Then I will flip them upside down and leave until the next morning. On day 2, the first thing in the morning, I rush to my plates to check for colonies. As you can see, I have about 30 colonies on the vector plus insert plate and nothing on the control plate, so I'm pretty confident that most colonies contain the construct that I want to make.